My wife had suffered from memory loss and Alzheimer's disease for the last 8 years. We managed at home on our own because she was in denial that there was anything wrong with her, and so that we didn't seek help at that stage. But unfortunately, 5 years ago, I developed a bladder tumour. This required hospital treatment and subsequent outpatient chemotherapy. At that point, I got in touch with Crossroads, who very promptly gave us help. They sent a carer along first thing in the morning to give me plenty of time to get for my hospital appointment, and I had the reassurance that they would wait with Sheila as long as necessary, and so I didn't need to worry if I was delayed at the hospital. They continued to give me that help during my treatment, and I was very grateful for that. Subsequently, about 3 years ago, things with my wife's condition had deteriorated quite a bit, and I was feeling a strain of looking after her 24 hours a day. At that point, we had a social work assessment, and it was arranged that she went for one day a week to the Dundonald House daycare, and on a Thursday morning that Crossroads would send someone to let me go to a music appreciation class, which I'd attended for some years. As a carer, you find that an ordinary week's work for most people is about 40 hours, but for a carer, it's 168 hours. And even a few hours respite care enabled one to carry on doing your caring for a much longer period of time. And we were very grateful to Crossroads that they provided me with that help, looking after, in this case, my wife, for another 3 years until eventually she had to go in for residential care this summer. My wife and I were very keen on bridge, and I was pleased that the Ayrshire District Bridge and some of the clubs have nominated Crossroads as their charity of choice, supporting a local charity which supports local people.